Hi, I'm Jacob with AltaPoint and HealthBiller Practice Management Systems. In today's video, we're going to discuss a little bit about signing up for the Electronically Prescribed Controlled Substances, or EPCS, which is powered by MDToolbox. There are three steps in order to use the EPCS that a prescriber will need to go through. First, of course, is to sign up for it. Second, you need to set the access controls for the controlled substances. And third, there needs to be a second factor authentication for each controlled substance that's sent. Two-factor authentication consists of two parts, something that you know, which is a password, and something that you have. Now, in this case, it's either going to be an app on your smartphone, or it's going to be a physical token, and we'll go over those a little later. There are two ways for a prescriber to access the sign-up in order to send controlled substances electronically. The first is to choose to sign up immediately after completing the initial ID proofing process. Click the I in the corner or click the link in the video description to see the video on the ID proofing process. The second way to access the sign up can be done at any time, and it's just through a menu item in the e-prescribe. An easy way to get there is to choose a patient and click the e-prescribe button on their file. Then, in the e-prescribe, you'll see these chevron-shaped arrows at the blue area just left of the patient's name. Those will open up the menu. Select the Setup and Tools option, and then EPCS Signup. This screen shows an overview of the steps that the provider will go through in order to register to send controlled substances electronically. So let's get started by either clicking on the Get Started tab or clicking on the title Get Started, select Token Type, and complete ID Proofing. For the purposes of this video, we're going to skip the Terms and Conditions page, but please feel free to read and understand those before agreeing to them. Also, the ID proofing mentioned in the steps has already been handled with the initial e-prescribing sign-up, so the process will continue with registering the token. So now the prescriber will need to decide whether to use a software token or a hardware token for their second factor authentication. The software token requires the prescriber to download and install a free app to a compatible smartphone from the device's application store, like Apple's App Store or Android's Google Play Store. The hardware token is a small key fob device which can fit onto a keychain. It has the same software as the mobile app, but it is on a small hardware device instead. If the prescriber chooses the hardware token, it will be mailed to the home address which was verified during the ID proofing process and can take 5 to 7 business days to arrive. And please be aware that there is an additional one-time fee that goes along with the hardware token, as it is a physical item that needs to be delivered. The software token is generally recommended because most prescribers will already have their phone with them and won't need to keep track of another device. Also, it's usually quicker because you're not waiting for that token to come in the mail. When you've received your token, whether that's by downloading the VIP Access app from your respective app store or by receiving the key fob in the mail, come to this screen and click I have it, register my token. In the two blue fields here, you'll enter and retype your password, so that matches. Now, this is something that you want to make sure that no one else has, that it's not used in other places. And remember, this is the first of the two factors. It's something you know. So make it something you'll be able to remember, but others won't have. The orange credential ID and security code fields come from that second factor, the thing that you have. So on the app, that comes here at the top of the screen. And on the key fobs, that comes on the back, just down here by the barcode. The security code is what proves that you have that second factor authentication token with you. Enter the code here and click register. So congratulations on getting your token set up. There is another verification activation code that's going to be sent to a verified phone number or address, again, much like the initial ID proofing. This extra security step is to keep the provider's identity and credentials safe, and it's required by DEA ruling and law. Before we talk about setting the access controls for EPCS, I would like to talk a little bit about what to do if the provider forgets a password or loses a token or gets a new cell phone. So let's go back to the EPCS signup under the Setup and Tools menu option, and you'll see that you're given a notice that you already have a token on file, as well as two new options under the Setup Two-Factor Credentials there in the second step. A, reset signing password, B, token maintenance. Clicking reset signing password asks the prescriber to enter and retype the password and then use the credentials from the two-factor authenticator to prove that this is in fact the prescriber making the change. Token maintenance offers the prescriber a few different options with regards to that token. Setting up a new phone or a key fob will deactivate the old token and set a new one up with the new app or key fob. Registering a second token is if you have a second authenticator. If you've forgotten your password and need to set up a new token, there's a couple options here for that as well. If you don't have a key fob and want to do that instead or in addition to your VIP access app, you can purchase that through the link here. And if you are not going to be using EPCS anymore, don't want to have the second factor authenticator, you can also deactivate the token from your account. The next thing that needs to be done is that the access control settings for the EPCS permissions need to be set. In order to do that, you need two people who have had access to the e-prescribe. The first person needs to be a token-holding prescriber. The second person can either be another token-holding prescriber or an administrative user. There are two ways for a prescriber to access EPCS access control permissions, both of which are under the Setup and Tools menu option. One way is to go back to the Steps screen of the EPCS signup and click on Access Control Set Permissions, or they can just click on the EPCS permissions. An admin user should access the permissions the second way. The top section of this screen deals with who will be signing off on the changes made to the permissions, while the lower section are the permissions themselves. Let's start by looking at the top section. The DEA requires two users to sign off on changes made to the EPCS permissions, so either the first user, who is a prescriber with a token, or the second user will have to be selected, depending on who's accessing the screen. Now let's talk about the permissions, which are given at the bottom of the screen. The checkbox for Has Validated Token can't be changed here. It's just an indicator of who's got a registered EPCS token. Access control managers are the people who can make changes to these permission settings. Now, there have to be at least two, and one of them have to be a prescriber with a token, but otherwise you can select as many as you want. An authorization verifier is an access control manager or managers who will be in charge of verifying the DEA registration and status for each prescriber using EPCS. This user is legally responsible to continually verify that the prescribers are in good standing and needs to immediately revoke privileges if the prescriber's token or password is lost, stolen, or compromised, if the DEA registration expires, if that registration is revoked, terminated, or suspended, or, of course, if the prescriber leaves the practice. If a user is given permission on the Allowed to Mark Ready to Sign EPCS checkbox, it means that they can mark a controlled substance ready for a prescriber to sign and send. The last permissions checkbox here is the Allowed to Sign and Send EPCS. So, of course, that's for a prescriber who's authorized to send the controlled substance prescriptions. Now, this is not available to someone who hasn't signed up for the two-factor authentication credentials. Once the Save button is pressed, this controlled substance sign-off screen will open and require the prescriber listed at the top to enter their signing password, the VIP access security code from their second-factor authentication token, and press the Sign and Authorize button to sign off on these changes. This screen is similar to the one that will open when a prescriber sends a controlled substance prescription. The main differences will be that the patient and prescription will be listed, the affidavit being completed will be in regards to the prescription rather than the permissions, and the Sign and Authorize button will instead say Sign and Send. Thank you for watching this video. If you want to watch a video about more specific information like writing and sending the electronic prescriptions, check out the link in the description for more tips and tricks on how to use your AltaPoint and HealthBiller practice management systems to more efficiently run your practice. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button below.